folks. Welcome to my first episode of Let's Perfect Some Songs and Future Things. As you can see, it's in English. It came out today. So I decided to try this. It's basically kind of like a Let's Play episode, but instead it's gonna be Let's Perfect the songs. I decided that I'll do three songs per episode. I'll see how this first one goes, and then if it seems like you guys enjoy it, then I'll do more in the future.
Okay. A Let's Play. Done a few of them before. 14,000 views. 445 likes. Seems like people enjoy it. Why don't I do one? Just rip off the idea. I mean, be inspired by this idea. Hello and welcome to my Project DIVA Future Tone Let's Play, which I decided to do completely on my own and not influenced by anybody or anything that I've seen. So we're going to play some songs on Extreme, get some perfects, and also play them on Extra Extreme as well, get some perfects, yeah. Play really well. So then people know that I'm pro. That's how long I have played it for. I've played it for a whole 15 hours. So you know that I'm pro. Done 10 minutes of video watching, so I'm just a god at watching PVs. So to start our Let's Play off, we are going to random a song and play whichever one it randoms. Oh, hang on, no, it's not on all of them. My bad. That was new, but it is okay because I'm going to choose the right one now, and this takes quite a long time. I don't really want to play that one. I don't really want to play that one either. Nah, not that one. Nah, not that one. Screw this. Oh, look at what it rounded on, randomly. Definitely not the only perfect I've got in Extreme. Yeah, I'm gonna stop acting like this is my first ever Let's Play, okay? Like, it's not really that funny anymore. Okay. Now, what's important when doing a Let's Play, especially of this, is you always have to have the swimsuits, so... Whoops. There's no quicker way to do this, is there? So what we're gonna do is... we're gonna go for the... hang on, the stoic stream look. There it is. I think. There we go, yeah, that's the stoic stream look. And for this one, we're gonna go for the standard Hisoski costume thing. Oh, and for the people who actually care, there are my macros. It's like I'm actually doing a proper Let's Play. Oh my god, wow. No. Oh right, this is a Let's Play, I'm supposed to talk. Forgot about that. By the way, we don't care about the goods. We're not going for score or anything. We're going for that perfect. This is actually a lot harder than it looks. I didn't really think this through when I wanted to take the nick out of it. But okay. And what I did remember to do before I even started this was do a couple of practices. Yesterday I decided to do it completely blind. That was... and stuff like that happened. Yay. But no, here on the TomBerri channel, we're all about endurance. We're gonna get this perfect. No matter how many goods we get. Back to the point where I was. No, not really. I let go of the square. But it's okay, because I don't really give a damn about my score. Every time I do a score attack anyway, it just gets beaten. Definitely not seeking psychiatric help. Cock. Oh, there's a reason why I don't play D.Va anymore. Yeah. Specifically Future Tone in general. That's actually embarrassing. That's really embarrassing. Of all places to screw up. Oh no. Left handed. It's just not gonna work. It's just not gonna work. It's so hard. What am I doing? This is so bad. Alright. I've got past the first bit. Can you believe it? 14%. You know when Hitoski does this? He usually does it in like one try. I think I've already had 10. And I haven't even got to 50% yet. I am a pro. I'm gonna regret saying that before the end. Realise how boring that entire playthrough of that song was. I apologise, I said absolutely nothing. But it's okay, because I've got some new editing software and I've probably added in loads of cool effects and green screens. Oh, new record. Just look at me, I'm such a pro. This is the point where you then go, oh, let's have a look at the leaderboard, see how sick I am. I'm probably like right at the top because I'm actually a pro. What was it? Oh no, it's the MMORPG addict, isn't it? It's on. And then you're like, oh no, I'm actually shit. No. What was my score again? I've forgotten. 749914. What am I doing? I'm pressing the wrong button. There we go. Where is it? There it is. Hold on. Oh, top 10! Actually suck my dick. That moment when you're only 200 off Hisosuke. Can you believe it? You know, people say there's a Let's Play curse, but this isn't a curse. This is, like, something good. What has happened? Well, that's good. Sick. One song down. Second one is going to be this one. For a reason you'll find out later on. As I decided to ask you guys some questions because, let's face it, the commentary on that first song was abysmal. It was god-awful. So I'm going to switch to post-commentary now. If I say anything interesting, I'll switch back to live. But, yeah. Going to answer some questions now. Or I'll just screw up like that. Jesus Christ. Hey, what's up? Post-commentary TomBerri here. So, as Live Tom was just saying, a few days ago I asked you to send me in some questions in the comments. And you did not disappoint, because the very first question I received was from Dynamic X, and the question is, would you give me the suck? Now, before I even answer the question, let's just assume, okay, that they are of legal age. I don't want to be exposed as a paedophile, okay? So let's just assume, I don't know otherwise, let's assume that they are. But to answer the question, yes I would. You watch my videos, I'd give you the suck, alright? Guy or gal, I'll give you the suck. How desperate did I sound? After that first question, I got a few questions asking why and when am I going to do custom PVs for Future Tone and XHD? And I'm sorry to burst your bubble, but there isn't any PS4 hacks out there, so I can't actually do any of those things. But believe me when I say this, if I could, I would definitely. Like, the 1080i resolution of the Vita TV is god-awful. The next question comes from Kevito, who asks, how old are you? And, well, I thought it was quite rude to ask a lady of their age, but I am 20 years old. And there was also a question from somebody that's disappeared, but they asked if I'm British, and yeah, I'm just sipping my tea and eating my crumpet. I legit hate that stereotype for British people, because I haven't eaten a crumpet in years, and tea, I just hate it. Just tastes awful. Coffee for the win. There is a reason why I hate tea, but that's a story for another day. Sky Yoru asks, and forgive me if I'd say any usernames wrong, if you had to choose between Kaito and Len, who would you choose? Be honest now. Well, being honest, I would choose Len every day of the week. And that sounds really wrong, now that I've said that aloud. Don't interpret that as I hate Kaito, but I don't know, he's just a bit too deep for me, personally. A few people asked who my favourite Vocaloid was, and I'd probably have to say one of the girls from the DIVA series. Probably Rin at the moment. Like, I really like Meltdown, really like Tengaku. Probably more that I can think of. A couple of people also asked what my favourite modded module or custom PV was, and I can't really choose a favourite. There's just too many good ones. In fact, they're all good. Like, way better suggestions than I could have ever come up with. But if I had to choose the ones which, like, really stand out to me, probably the Magnet Len and Kaito one, just to get that out of the way. That one was just funny. The glossy mixture one with the extra characters, Toho, Haku, Neru. That one put a lot of work into. Probably the the Len Lots of Laughs one, that one was quite good. The Cantarella one, that Miku module looks really good. There's probably loads more, but I honestly can't think of them off the top of my head. It's also a bit subjective, is this question, because I haven't got through all the requests yet, so I don't know if there's some extreme, mega, amazing one yet. So, yeah, maybe I'll add in post, in editing, if there's any even greater ones which I haven't mentioned. I have also been asked what my favourite unmodded module was from any D.Va game, and also what my favourite modules for each Project D.Va character, and my favourite module is probably Miku's Rocking Stone. Like, if there's one thing you've got to give Project D.Va X credit for, it's the modules. They are amazing. That's obviously my favourite for Miku. My favourite for Rin is Burning Stone. My favourite for Luca is Villainess. My favourite for Len is Holy Lancer. And my favourite for Kaito is Majestic Stone. Frostflower also asks, can I see if it's possible to see all of the underwear or boxes of the modules? Yes, you can. There they are. And they also ask, can I slap a Vocaloid right now? You do what you've got to do. And if you want to slap a Vocaloid, you do it. Don't let your dreams be dreams. God, that's an old meme. I've done it. I've just, that triangle every single time. I should just let go and press it. But it's all about that score, isn't it? All about that score. Every time. And I start off with 3 goods. So that's good. But it's not. It's not. It's not at all. Better. The next couple of questions are in regards to Mikadeu, where Scarf asks, when will Sega add Mikadeu to Future Tone and Fernando El Pelon? Will Mikadeu ever dominate the world? Well, Scarf, I think we both know the answer to this question. Sega are too lazy to add Mikadeu. They can't be bothered to go through all 220 plus songs and recreate all the animations for it. It'd be really cool if they did add it as part of like the season pass and make it a little bit more value for money. And Fernando, will she ever dominate the world? Well, that's not really for me to decide. Question from Ryu says, do you have a dick? Well, let
me just check.
Yeah, I found it. Yeah, I do have a dick. Chazza808 then asks, do you have a big willy? Well, does sub 1 inch count as big? 2 really interesting facts that you should know about me. Number 1, my dick has been in the Guinness Book of World Records. And number 2, I'm banned from the library.
That wasn't a very funny joke, was it?
102%, but I got a bad. I got a wrong. So it's definitely doable. I'll have this as a placeholder score in case I do it perfect. Rhythm asks, Miku, or Miku? There's probably some hidden meaning there, which I don't understand, but I think I'm going to have to go with option E, Miku. Kirani P asks, which cross-dresser Len is best Len? I would probably have to say the one that you're using for your profile picture, the Lots of Laughs one. That one's pretty good. Or the original Strawberry Witch Len, which I created all by myself. Crossfire Track asks, Miku x Kaito or Miku x Len? And I'll let the game decide which one of those two. Sack asks, are you a roadman? And I think because I play D.Va, that automatically means no. But my friend Ben is, and he has an Instagram page with no pictures on it. But he still wants me to advertise it, so here it is. Just a blank Instagram. Girl version of Red asks, which I'm pretty sure is pink, but asks, why isn't Oliver any English singing Vocaloids in Project D.Va, excluding Luca and Gummy? And Fernando, this is my Q&A, you know. Why are you answering my questions? Okay. And then I completely missed the bloody triplet. Ah, for crying out loud. I just want to get this done, please. I did it again. I did the exact same thing again. Every single time. I should just let go. I'm so annoyed with myself. Such an idiot every time. A few questions left now, and Galactic Angel Lunar Eclipse asks, if one of Miku's modules never belonged to her, which module would it be, and who would it suit better on? I would have to say Twinkle Star and Len, or for a more serious one, Demonster and Rin. Two people asked, would you rather go down on Luca or Haku? My answer is, I'm not picky, either.
Just really desperate, that's all.
And a question similar to the first one, what do you prefer, orange or apple? I like orange juice over apple juice, but I like to eat an apple over an orange. Okay. The next question asks, where does your channel name come from? And, well, it pretty much just comes from my first name and, like, half of my last name. I put them together and, I don't know, just sort of worked, I suppose. Much better than Thomas B 2685, like... doesn't really roll off the tongue, that one. Capo asks, what other games do you like to play? And, well, a bit of everything, really. The best way to check what games I've played is to just go on my PSN profile, look at my trophies for stuff that I've got. And I'm not just saying that because I've got a lot of them, but, yeah, that's the quickest way to find out. Thomas B 2685, by the way. Most recently, the games I've been playing are Nier, and probably because this video won't be out in time, I'll be playing Persona 5. A few people have asked who my favourite producer is, and it's probably Yutsu P, or at least that's the one that sticks out the most to me. To be honest, I never really pick a favourite because then, I don't know, you're open to everything, I suppose. And then leading on from that kind of question, what sort of music would I like to see in Project DIVA next? Something less safe. Safe in quotation marks. Like, they've started doing that with X, thankfully, with, like, Holy Lance and that one that's in the Chaos Melody, the Len one, I can't remember what it's called off the top of my head. But yeah, they've started going a little bit less safe, if that makes sense. And the final question I'm going to be answering, which was asked by a lot of you, is how I first got into Project DIVA. Now, this is quite a tale, so I hope you sat comfortably, and I shall begin. Now let's set the scene. Rewind back to 6th of November 2013, when all was good in the world, or at least for me. No university, so everything was good at that time. And the PlayStation YouTube channel released a trailer for something called Hatsune Miku Project DIVA F. That's little F. The announcement trailer for the West, in quotation marks, for the Vita version. I saw the trailer. Even in the trailer it says, are you hungry for new Vita games? At that point, yeah, I was, to be honest. The Vita was dying. Nothing new was coming out at that point. I remember seeing it and thinking, wow, this legitimately looks like trash. This is the end for the Vita, if they're just pushing stuff like this. Fast forward about 5 months, and they release another trailer for the demo and the launch of DIVA the next week. So I decide, sure, why not? I've got nothing else to play. Let's get the demo. Let's give it a go. See how good it could be. Long story short, loved the demo. Bought the game, then got it for PS3, then started playing edits, then moved on to F2nd, and you know the story from there. That's it for all the questions. If your question did not get answered, wait till a little bit later in the video and it might get answered. Hopefully by now I've got the perfect. Yes, boys. 104% point one. Respectable. Adequate. Decent. 641575. 641. Remember that number? 641 for all the people at home. Our survey says a number probably. What was the song that I just played? Rushing. There it is. 641, wasn't it? Wow. Okay. Yep. seven. It was like 575 or something. So 63rd place. Cool. Two songs down. Now just the third.